You're watching Head Start with me, Karen Davila. Ombudsman Merceditas Gutierrez is expected to give her farewell speech in her office when she goes there right after our program. Are you doing that today? Now, what many may not know is if she is willing to take on a new role, which some people are asking, as a state witness. Willard Cheng has this report.
President Aquino and Ombudsman Merceditas Gutierrez were all smiles as Gutierrez submitted her letter of resignation. This seeming lack of tension was a stark contrast to the word war between the two camps over the Ombudsman's looming impeachment trial. In her resignation letter addressed to the President, Gutierrez vowed to work for good governance even after she leaves her post. President Aquino now says he is open to the idea of making Gutierrez a state witness in possible criminal cases against officials of the Arroyo administration.
If she testifies, then I think we will welcome. But we do not intend to force anybody. We think there are substantial pieces of evidence for numerous cases already present.
But private prosecutors in the cancelled impeachment trial are taking issue over a number of appointments Gutierrez made before she resigned. They say three of the seven employees assigned as new assistant ombudsman are not only close to Gutierrez, but also to former deputy ombudsman for Luzon, Mark Halandoni.
Kung magre-review, sino man yan na bagong ombudsman, eh nakatali ang kamay kung ano lang isasumite ng mga na-appoint na ito na inaitanim ni ombudsman Gutierrez.
Mga resolution creating the positions without even the approval of the DBM. These are the stalwarts and the alter ego of Merceditas and Halandoni.
The private prosecutors are calling on the next ombudsman to review the appointments Gutierrez made. The ombudsman declined to comment on the issue. Willard Cheng, ABS-CBN News.
Now, critics of Ombudsman Merceditas Gutierrez frown upon the idea of having her as a state witness. Bayan Muna Secretary General Renato Reyes says Malacanang should first consider if Gutierrez's statements will be enough to prosecute the former president. But Gutierrez's spokesperson, Attorney Tomas Sequia, says he's not even certain if Gutierrez will be willing to testify.
I would not say that she's willing, but she said that if a subpoena is issued, she will have to comply with the subpoena. You cannot naman avoid the subpoena. You cannot disregard the subpoena.
On Hot Copy today, the woman who is still making headlines after her resignation, who resigns and still makes headlines after the resignation. Outgoing Ombudsman Merceditas Gutierrez and her daughter, Attorney Marge Gutierrez, will be joining us today. Now, good day to both of you. Ma'am, I just want to thank you so much for trusting us and coming over to the show. I mean, I know this was very difficult, but I want to ask you, how have you been after the resignation?
Well, thank you, Karen. I feel a little bit relaxed now.
Yeah.
You know, this impeachment trial will take costs and will take the time of our senators.
So yes, yes.
Country first.
Country first.
Over personal vindication.
Country first over personal vindication.
Yes. No, then, of course, my family then. Because they're worried that the whole process might take a toll on my health, and we need a full-time ombudsman and a full-time Senate and a full-time Congress to do the work.
Yeah.
And they should concentrate on legislative work.
Yes. Now, so, I'm curious, what was the tipping point for you personally? Because I've interviewed you twice, and you were always very certain that you would have been acquitted, there wasn't enough evidence, and that you had said, I will take this to the end to clear my name. So for a woman or any person to come to a crossroad of making a different choice.
Mahirap
yeah.
For me, Karen, to really think about it. But as I said in my statement, my family, my, of course, the office, and the nation.
Yeah. Now, did Marge...
So, yun na lahat ang pinag-usap, yun na lahat ang aking consideration in coming up with the decision.
Now, did Marge have anything to do with it?
Yeah? Well, I'm family.
Yeah, yeah. So, what did you say? Did you say, Mom, Are you gonna cry?
No, early. No, no, I'm trying to remember. I was trying to remember what happened that day. So I was always telling her, Mom, always pray, ask for wisdom and understanding. Yeah. And if your heart you find that you do need to do such, then I will support you. Okay.
But you've been such a fabulous daughter. Huh? I mean, you serve in her office. You work with her. You face terrible media like us. No, I mean, really. No, I swear, that harass you nonstop. And did you tell her? I mean, it must have been painful at some point, you know, knowing what was in the news, and then...
It was. It was really hard for me as well. Yes. But every time I'm faced with such a dilemma, parang ba't naman ganito, like that, I always think, you know, forget it. I'm here for my mom. I love her so much. I'll do anything for her. So yeah. That's it lang. It's the love lang talaga.
Yeah. Can you have tissue?
No,
for you.
I'm speaking from the heart. So.
Yeah, I know. I'm happy that you're speaking from the heart.
This is the only thing that impels me to do anything and everything for her. Diba? Payback time na eh. I'm big enough na. Diba? I'm not a child anymore.
I paid for it.
No. It's the least I can do as a daughter. And any daughter, any child for that matter, will do the same thing if they were in this situation.
Yes. But at any point, did you tell your mom, Mom, I think it's time. You should just let this go? Or, I mean, what was your voice in all this?
Me, I was always her support.
Okay.
I was always telling her, Mom, we can do this.
Yes.
I was talagang her rara girl. I'm like, Mom, whatever you decide, talagang I will support you. Parang, we have to be strong in this. We can do this. Like that lang.
Yeah.
Like a kid na parang, Ma.
Yeah.
I was always cheering her.
But of course, lagi sa akin ang decision.
Yeah.
I think the one personally affected.
Yes.
They're also affected, but not much as I am, because I am the real person.
Involved.
Yeah.
Now, ma'am, if you don't mind, I heard from my sources that one of the major reasons also was that your mom is sick.
Yeah.
Okay.
She's undergoing dialysis weekly, and you know, her television.
Yeah.
Wala na talagang sarado na.
Uh-oh.
And
let her watch.
Our maids see to it na wala muna siyang mapapanood na
yun. Yeah. And is it true that she had said, actually, kinalabutan ako when I heard this, I wanted to ask if it were true. I didn't want to warn your daughter that I was going to ask this, but is it true your mother had told you na parang, Mercy, baka mamatay na ako, ayoko naman na something like, hindi na ayoko something like, ang kahuli-hulihan ay iniisip nila yung pangalan mo or something like that, or something like that.
No, nothing like that. No, she was in the hospital one time and she saw, she was able to watch the comments of some politicians, and then she told the maids, and she told me later, to the maids, she told them, bakit naman inaapi nila aking anak?
Mm-mm. Yeah.
So, there were comments from her na.
Yeah.
I felt really very, very bad.
Yeah. And that was it for you?
So, that was the time that I started to think about.
Mm-mm. And did you talk to your mother? I'm curious.
Oh, yeah.
Uh-oh. Mm-mm. I mean, you're a very strong woman. I've never seen you like this, but clearly, yes, it's all right. Here, ma'am. But clearly, this was the one thing that, that you wouldn't sacrifice.
Karen, it really took a long time for me to find out really and figure out what would be the best thing. And I said my considerations, my family. So, ito nga, pinag-uusapan lang natin ng family, a mother.
Yes,
you never saw me in this.
Yes, I never did. Yeah. And I don't think anyone has.
Uh-oh. When it comes to family, talaga, you really break down, di ba?
Yes. And is your mother okay now, by the way?
Yes, she's okay. And she's undergoing dialysis. No, I thought the last thing that I should hear, no, from a doctor would be, for any procedure, would be dialysis. You know what the neuro The doctor told me,
yes,
that the public is not informed on the benefits of dialysis. Mm-mm. You know, after a month of dialysis, kasi twice a week yon.
Yeah.
You know, she was able to eat very well.
Yes, yes.
And her complexion improved. Kasi medyo maputi siya. Kasi medyo may Chinese blood kami.
Yeah.
Grandparents were Chinese. So, nag-improve ang complexion. She has good appetite. At saka medyo active na siya ngayon. And then, learning that I'm okay now, she's happy.
Okay. So, now, I want to take it on a bit of a lighter note. I understand. I understand you both. But, I mean, this is a very light question. Did you have to choose resigning the day William and Kate got married? I mean, seriously. Did you know that was going to happen?
No planning, Karen.
No planning?
No planning.
Really,
huh? It was a decision on my part.
Yeah.
Alam mo, hindi naman tayo. Basta I always prayed hard. No, pinakamadaming dasal na nagawa ko.
Sa tanong buhay yun, no?
Impeachment case was filed against me. Pinakamaraming dasal na nagawa ko. Pinakamaraming santo na tawag ko. At because of that, I was able to paint portraits of saints.
Are you serious?
Relax, sir. I have the portrait of Padre Pio, Saint Pio.
You painted it?
Yeah, of course. Mother Teresa.
Don Bosco.
Don Bosco. Sa tindi ng ano ha? Sa tindi ng stress.
And Mother Teresa and Saint Thomas Aquinas, our patron saint. May patron saint kami sa Bataan. Inherited by my father, my grandfather, Alejo Consuni, kasi yung mga Consuni sin Bataan. Family ng mga religyoso. So I even have a grand uncle who was a Jesuit, one of the first Filipino Jesuits.
Yeah.
Kaya lahat ng magkakapatid, may mga santo sila sa amin town, sa Samal. So kung mayroong mga occasion, lahat ng mga santo sa Samal, from my relatives, isa doon sa santo, si St. Thomas Aquinas. So I was able to paint a portrait of St. Thomas Aquinas and prayed.
Ganun sa very hard.
Okay.
Now, how's your husband?
My husband is okay, but he's also sick.
Are you serious?
Yeah, he's also sick.
If you don't mind, I mean, what is it?
Prostate.
Okay. So you've been dealing with so many things in your family. I understand. Now, I mean, you have senators that also lauded your resignation by saying that it was admirable, that you didn't have to put the country through such a divisive period. Mm-hmm. You had Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile, I think Senator Cheese Escudero said it too. Yeah. How did that make you feel?
I feel happy and at least people, especially the senators, understand me.
Yeah, and then you do have that sector wherein you're in a no-win situation. I mean, you resign, and then they say that there was a secret deal. I mean, they ask you to resign, and then you do it. And then there's a whole thing of, you have Bagong Alianza Makabayan Secretary General Renato Reyes, that you must have struck a deal with President Aquino.
Grabe. It's too much.
Okay, so no deal. Now, what were you and the president discussing? I mean, we can only imagine, really.
Of course, I cannot tell the public what really transpired, but we discuss all about everything that...